Dear students, I am Dr. Jyotsna Shirsagar, Department of Genetics and Plant Breeding. In the last lectures, we are discussing the light reactions. Now we are discussing the dark reaction of photosynthesis. The fact that the non-photochemical process means the dark reaction process. It involves in the photosynthesis was established by the Blackmon. This dark reaction is established by the Blackmon in the year 1905. And this is the second step in the mechanism of photosynthesis. The chemical process of photosynthesis occurring independent of a light is called as dark reaction. In the dark reaction, light is not required. It takes place in the stroma of the chloroplast. Light reaction is occurred in a thylakoid membrane. Okay, and a dark reaction is occurred in a stroma of the chloroplast. The dark reaction is purely enzymatic and it is a slower than the light reaction. The dark reaction occurs also in a presence of light. Okay, means dark reaction is also occur in light and dark also. Okay, in a dark reaction, the sugar are synthesized from the CO2. The energy poor CO2 is fixed to energy rich carbohydrates using the energy rich compounds ATP and the assimilatory power NADPH2 of a light reaction. The process is called as carbon fixation or the carbon assimilation. Since the Blackmon demonstrated the existence of dark reaction, the reaction is also called as Blackmon's reaction. This dark reaction is also called as Blackmon's reaction because the Blackmon's established this reactions or the this process dark reaction process or mechanisms. Okay, in the dark reaction there are the three types of cyclic reactions. One is the Kelvin cycle, or this Kelvin cycle is also called as a C3 cycles, means three carbon cycles are stable product, first products. Okay, HSK and slacks, hatch and slacks pathway or the C4 pathway. With this C4 pathway, four carbon compounds has been found as the first stable compounds. This is a C4 pathway. And next is a CAM pathway. Okay. We are discussing the Kelvin cycle, or let's see the Kelvin cycle or the C3 cycle. It is a cyclic reaction occur in a dark phase of photosynthesis. In this reaction, CO2 is converted into the sugar and hence it is a process of carbon fixation. The Kelvin cycle was the first observed by Melvin Calvin in a chlorella. Means this Kelvin cycle firstly observed in chlorella. Chlorella is a unicellular green algae, and which scientist is firstly observed? This is the Melvin Calvin. That's why this cycle is called as Calvin cycle. Calvin was awarded as a Nobel Prize for this work in the year 1961. Okay, since the first stable compounds in a Calvin cycle is the three carbon compounds, 3-phosphoglyceric acid. The cycle is also called as C3 cycle. The reaction of Kelvin cycle occur in a three phases. First is a carboxylative phases. Second one is the reductive phase. And third one is the regenerative phase. How many phases are there? Three phases. One is the carboxylative phase. Second one is the reductive phase. And third one is the regenerative phase. Let's start with this phases are the synthesizing carbohydrates via the Kelvin cycle. Okay, then Kelvin cycle, aka Kelvin Basin cycle. This Kelvin cycle is also called as aka Kelvin Benson cycle. CO2 incorporate into the carbohydrate. The precursors to other organic molecules and in which the energy storage, it requires the massive input of energy, and for the every 6 carbon atoms it's incorporated the 18 ATP and 12 NADP H2 must be used. At the time of production, or the products is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate G3P. Let's this Kelvin cycle is explained in three phases. One is the carbon fixation, then second phase is the reduction and carbohydrate production, and third one is the regeneration of RUBP. Okay, then at the time of carbon fixation, CO2 incorporate into the RUBP using the RUBISCO. Okay, this CO2 is incorporated into the RUBP using the RUBISCO, and this reaction products is a 6 carbon intermediate that splits into the 2-3 phosphoglycerate molecules, 3PG. In a second phase, this second phase is the reduction and carbohydrate production. ATP is used to convert the 3PG into the 1,3 biphosphoglycerate, 1,3 BPG. NADP H electron reduce it to the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. Then 6 CO2 it's produce the 12 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. Only 2 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates molecules used for carbohydrate formation. Then 10 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate molecules must be used for the regeneration of RUBP. Then phase 3, regeneration of RUBP. 10 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates are converted into the 6 RUBP using the 6 ATP. Then in the Kelvin cycle was determined by using the isotopes labeling method. Okay, how to determine this cycle? You use the isotope labels to the this molecules. You use the C14 label to the CO2 injected into the culture of green algae. Okay, it's allowed to incubate the different length of the times. It separated newly made radio labeled molecules using the 2-dimethyl paper chromatography. Okay, to determine the Kelvin cycle, we use the radio label molecules, for example 2-dimethyl paper chromatographs, auto radiography, radiation from the carbon atom C14 label molecules makes a dark spot on the film. Identify the C14 labeled spots and ordered they appeared. The Malvin Kelvin received this research. They get the Nobel Prize in the year 1961. Then variation in photosynthesis. Environmental condition can influence both the efficiency and the way of the Kelvin cycle workers. How its variation is occur, then the light intensity, temperature and water availability. Okay, there's a RUBISCO. you write only short note on the Rubisco. It is a normally Rubisco add a CO2 to RUBP to make a 3-phosphoglycerate. RUBP plus CO2, it gives 2-3-phosphoglycerate. Since 3-phosphoglycerate has a 3-carbon compounds, plants that requires this form of a carbon fixation are called as a C3 plants. Then 90% of plant species on earth are C3 plants. Example, oak tree. Oak tree is a C3 plants. Okay. Then what is mean by photorespiration? Recently, it has been observed that the light affects the respiration, and the rate of respiration in a light may be 3 to 5 times higher than the respiration in a darkness, and this called as a photorespiration. Rubisco can also add the O2 to RUBP. RUBP plus the O2, it forms the 3-phosphoglycerate plus phosphoglycerate. Phosphoglycerate it gives to glycolate or the organic molecules, it's plus CO2. Affinity for the CO2 is 10x better. So this occurs only when the CO2 is low and O2 is higher. Phosphoglycerate is eventually released as a CO2. So photorespiration use the O2 and release the CO2. Release the CO2 is wasteful since normally used for the growth. So photorespiration decrease the efficiency of photosynthesis. More likely in hot and dry environment when a CO2 is low and a O2 is high may protect the plants from the free radicals. Then C4 and CAM pathway have evolved a mechanism to minimize the photorespiration. In C4 plants, it makes the oxaloacetate 4-carbon molecules in the first step of the carbon fixation. The leaves have a 2-cell layer organization, mesophyll cells and bundle sheath cells. In a mesophyll cell, CO2 enters via stroma and 4-carbon compounds are formed. PEP carboxylase does not promote the photorespiration. In a bundle sheath cells, 4-carbon molecules transfer that release steady supply of CO2 and minimizing the photorespiration. Okay, in C4 plants, 2 cells of layers are organized. One is a mesophyll cells and bundle sheath cells. Which is the better, C3 or C4? It depends on the environment. In a warm, dry climate, C4 plants conserves the water and prevents the photorespiration. In cooler climate, C3 plants use less energy to fix the CO2, and 90% of the plants are the C3 plants. You see, this one is the C4 plant. C4 plants. Okay. You see, this is the bundle sheath. Yellow color is the bundle sheath and the outer covering is the mesophyll cells. Okay. These the mesophyll cells are protective layer and around the bundle sheath cells, so they are not exposed to the high O2. And what is the function of bundle sheath? It is the site of Calvin cycle. In that, the higher O2 and low CO2 diffuses around the mesophyll cells. Okay, and this outer covering is the epidermal cells, and in between veins are present. And this, you see, this is the stroma. Okay, and you see the total cells of the or the compounds of the cells. Okay, outer covering is the mesophyll cells. In between, the bundle sheaths are present, and in between bundle sheath vessels are present. Okay, in a bundle sheath, in bundle sheath is the Kelvin cycle is happen. CAM pathway or CAM plants. Some C4 plants separate the processing times. Crassulacean acid metabolism. What is the full form of CAM pathway? Crassulacean acid metabolism. CAM plants open their stomata at the night, not a morning time. CO2 enters and is converted to the malic acid. Stomata close during the day to conserve the water, and these CAM plants are present in a desert or less water area. Oxaloacetate converted to the malate or malic acid. Malate broken down into the CO2 to the drive the Kelvin. Okay, you see, this one is the C4 plants, this is the C4 plants, and these are the CAM plants. Okay, crassulacean acid okay, in this two cells are present, mesophyll cells and bundle sheath. Okay, and this is in which that CO2 is essentially incorporated into the four carbon molecules, and the four molecules carbon molecule releases CO2, which is incorporated into the Kelvin cycle. Okay, species evolved from the one generation to the next is a CAM pathway. C4 plants and CAM plants adaptations evolves to help the plants involved in hot and dry environments to conserve the water and minimize the photorespiration. And you see, this is the Kelvin cycle. First stable product is a cis of 4 carbon atoms. Kelvin cycle having the 3 phases. Okay, one is the carboxylative phases, in which the 6 molecules of CO2 or carbon dioxide are accepted by the 6 molecule of 5 carbon compounds via ribulose 1,5-diphosphate to form a 6 molecule of an unstable intermediate 6 carbon compounds. And this reaction is catalyzed by the enzymes carboxydiamutase ribisco. 6 carbon compounds plus 6 RUBP, it gives 6 unstable intermediate 6 carbon compounds. It's a carboxydiamutase. 6 molecules of the unstable carbon compound, 6 carbon compounds are converted by the addition of 6 molecules of water into the 12 molecules of 3 phosphoglyceric acid, and this reaction is also catalyzed by the enzyme carboxydiamutase. And 6 unstable intermediate 6 carbon compounds plus 6 H2O, it gives a carboxydiamutase 3 PGA phosphoglyceric acid. 3 phosphoglyceric acid is the first stable product of the dark reaction of the photosynthesis, and since it is the 3 carbon compounds, and this cycle is known as C3 cycle. Second phase is the reductive phase, in which 12 molecules of 3PGA, phosphoglyceric acid, are phosphorylated by the 12 molecules of ATP. It produced in the light reaction to yield the 12 molecules of 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid and 12 molecules of ADP. And this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme phosphoglycerate kinase. Then 3PGA, 3-phosphoglyceric acid plus ATP, 1-diphosphoglyceric acid plus ADP in the presence of kinases. Okay, this kinases enzymes is used to catalyze the 3PGA to 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. Then 12 molecules of 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid are reduced with the use of 12 molecules of NADPH2 produced in a light reaction to form a 12 molecules of 3-phosphoglycerate. And this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme triose phosphate dehydrogenase. 1,3 dehydrogenase plus NADPH2, it forms triose phosphate dehydrogenase 3PGL plus NADP plus H3PO4. Third phase is the regenerative phase. In the regenerative phase, the ribose diphosphate is regenerated, and the regenerative phase is called as the pentose phosphate pathway or hexomonophosphate shunt pathway. And it involves the following steps. One is the sum of the molecules of 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde converted into the dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Both the 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone phosphate then united in the presence of the enzymes aldolase to form a fructose 1,6-diphosphate. 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde to triose phosphate isomerase dihydroxyacetone PO4. 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde plus DHP aldose fructose 1,6-diphosphate. Fructose 1,6-phosphate is converted into the fructose 6-phosphate in the presence of phosphatase. Okay, some of the molecules of 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde instead of forming the hexo sugars are diverted to regenerate the ribulose 1,5-diphosphate. Then 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde reacts with the fructose 6-phosphate in the presence of enzyme transskeleton to form a erythrose 4-phosphate. This is a 4-carbon sugar, and xylulose 5-phosphate, that is a 5-carbon sugar. Then erythrose 4-phosphate combines with the dihydroxyacetone phosphate in the presence of enzyme aldolase to form a pseudoheptylose 1,7-diphosphate. It's a 7-sugar. Then pseudoheptylose 1,7-diphosphate loses 1-phosphate group in the presence of the enzyme phosphatase to form a pseudoheptylose 7-phosphate. Then pseudoheptylose phosphate reacts with the 3-phosphoglyceraldehyde in the presence of transskeleton to form a xylose 5-phosphate and ribose 5-phosphate, both the 5-carbon sugars. Ribose 5-phosphate is converted into the ribulose 1,5-diphosphate in the presence of enzymes phosphopentose kinase. This enzyme is used to convert the ribulose 5-phosphate to 1,5-diphosphate and ATP. The molecule of exoglucose 5-phosphate are also converted into the molecule of ribulose monophosphate. The ribulose monophosphate is phosphorylated by the ATP to form a ribulose diphosphate and ADP, thus completing the Kelvin cycle. In the dark reaction, CO2 is fixed to carbohydrates and the CO2 acceptor is a ribulose diphosphate is a regenerated. In the Kelvin cycle, 12 NADPH2 and 80 ATP are required to fix the 6 CO2 molecules into the 1 hexo sugar molecules. 6 CO2 plus 12 NADPH2 plus 18 ATP is equal to glucose plus 12 NADP plus 18 ADP plus 18 PI. C4 cycle or hatch and slash pathway. Before we are discussing the Kelvin cycle or C3 pathway, then now we are discussing the C4 cycle or the hatch and slash pathway. It is the alternate pathway of the C3 cycle to fix the CO2. In this cycle, the first formed stable compound is the 4 carbon compounds. First product is the oxaloacetic acid, hence it is called as the C4 cycles. The pathway is also called as a hatch and slash, as they worked out the pathway in the year 1966, and it is also called as a C4 dicarboxylic acid pathway. C4 dicarboxylic acid pathway. This pathway is commonly seen in the many grasses, sugarcane, maize, sorghum and amaranthus. C4 plants or cycles are present in a long leaf or in a sugarcane leaf, grasses, maize like leaf. Okay, then C4 plant shows a different types of leaf anatomy. The chloroplasts are dimorphic in a nature. In the leaves of these plants, the vascular bundles are surrounded by the bundle sheath of the larger parenchymatous cells, and thus the bundle sheath cells have a chloroplast, and these chloroplasts of the bundle sheath are larger, like the grana, and contains the starch grains. The chloroplast is a mesophyll cells. In a mesophyll cells are smaller and also contains the grana. This peculiar anatomy of the leaves of the C4 plants is called as a Kranz anatomy. The bundle sheath called as the bigger and look like a ring or the wreath. Kranz in a German means wreath, and hence it is called as a Kranz anatomy. The C4 cycle involves two carboxylation reactions, one taking place in a chloroplast of mesophyll cells and another in a chloroplast of the bundle sheath cells. You see the cross section of the C3 and C4 plants or leaves. This is the C3 plants. And this one is the C4 plants. In this C3 plants, only mesophyll cells are present. In the C4 plants, that's the mesophyll cells are present, bundle sheaths are present, then vessels are present. Okay, in this cells only mesophyll cells are present. Okay. C4 cycles or hatch a slacks pathway, there are the four steps. One is the carboxylation, second one is the breakdown, then splitting and phosphorylation. These four steps are involved in C4 cycles. Then you see, this is the flowchart of HSK pathway, hatch and slacks pathway, or C4 pathway or C4 plants. Okay, in which you see, this is the two cells. One is the mesophyll cells and second one is the bundle sheath cells. Okay, there is the two transport system. Path two transports way, that's the one is the pyruvic acid to pyruvate and the malic acid to malate. Okay, in a next slide we are discussing this pathway properly. In C4 cycle, one step is the carboxylation. It takes place in the chloroplast of mesophyll cells. This carboxylation takes place in chloroplast of the mesophyll cells. Phosphoenopyruvate, a 3-carbon compounds pick up the CO2 and change into the 4-carbon oxalate in the presence of water. And this reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme phosphoenolpyruvate carboxylates. Then next step is a breakdown. Oxaloacetate breaks down readily into the 4-carbon malate and aspartate in the presence of the enzyme transaminase and malate dehydrogenase. And these compounds diffuse from the mesophyll cells into the bundle sheath cells. Then next step is the splitting. In the sheath cells, malates and aspartate split enzymatically to yield a free CO2 and 3-carbon pyruvate. The CO2 is used in Kelvin cycle in the sheath cells. The second carboxylate occurs in the chloroplast of the bundle sheath cells. The CO2 is accepted by the 5-carbon compounds ribulose, diphosphate in the presence of the enzymes carboxydiamidase and ultimately yield 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Some of the 3-phosphoglyceric acid is utilized in the formation of sugar and the rest regenerate ribulose diphosphate. Then next step is a phosphorylation. The pyruvate molecules is transferred to chloroplast of the mesophyll cells, where it is phosphorylated to regenerate the phosphoenol pyruvate in the presence of ATP. And this reaction is catalyzed by the pyruvate phosphokinase. And the phosphoenol pyruvate is regenerated. In hatch and slack pathway, the C3 and C4 cycle of carboxylation are linked, and this is due to the Kranz anatomy of the leaf. C3 plants are more efficient in photosynthesis than the C4 plant. The enzyme phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase of C4 cycle is found to have a more affinity for the CO2 than the ribulose diphosphate carboxylase of the C3 cycle in the fixing the molecular CO2 in the organic compounds during the carboxylation. Then next cycle is the crystallization acid metabolism. What is the full form of CAM? Crystallization acid metabolism. and this cycle is called as CAM cycle. CAM is a cyclic reaction occurring in the dark phases of a photosynthesis in the plants of the Crucilaceous. It is a CO2 fixation process wherein the first product is the malic acid, and it is the third alternate pathway of the Kelvin cycle. It's occurring in the mesophyll cells. The plants exhibiting CAM cycle are called as a CAM plants, and most of the CAM plants are succulent. For example, Bryophyllum, Kalanchoin, Crucilian, Sedium, Kalanian, etc. It is also seen in the certain plants of the cactus, example Opitina, Orchid and Pineapple, Pineapple family, etc. CAM plants are usually succulent and they grow under the extremely xeric condition or xerophytic condition. In these plants, the leaves are succulent or fleshy. The mesophyll cells have a larger number of chloroplasts, and the vascular bundles are not surrounded by well-defined bundle-shaped cells. In these plants, the stomata remains open during the night and closed during the daytime. The CAM plants are adapted to the photosynthesis and survival under the adverse xeric conditions. CAM plants are not as efficient as C4 plants in the photosynthesis, but they are better suited to condition of extreme desiccation. CAM involves two steps: acidification and deacidification. You see, this is the flow chart of the CAM plants. Okay, one is the this two processes is this the one is the dark processes and one is the light processes. In dark situations, stomata are open, and in a light, stomata are closed. Okay, we are discussing this pathway in a next slide. One is the acidification and second one is a deacidification. In a darkness, the stored carbohydrates are converted into the phosphoenyl pyruvate by the process of glycolysis. The stomata in the CAM plants are open in a dark and they allow a free diffusion of CO2 from the atmosphere into the leaf. Now, the phosphoenyl pyruvic acid carboxylate by the enzyme phosphoenyl pyruvic acid carboxylase and is converted into the oxaloacetic acid. The oxaloacetic acid is then reduced to malic acid in the presence of the enzymes malic dehydrogenase. The reaction requires NADPH2 produced in the glycolysis. The malic acid produced in a dark is stored in the vacuum, and the malic acid increases the acidity of the tissues. Second one is the deacidification. During daytime, when the stomata are closed, the malic acid is decarboxylated to the produce the pyruvic acid, and it involves the carbon dioxide in the presence of the malic acid or malic enzymes. When the malic acid is removed, the acidity decreases the cells, and this is called as a deacidification. One molecule of NADP plus is reduced in this reaction. The pyruvic acid may be oxidized to CO2 by the pathway of Krebs cycle, or it may be reconverted to phosphoenyl pyruvic acid and synthesize the sugar by C3 cycle. The CO2 released by the deacidification of the malic acid is accepted by ribulose, diphosphate and is fixed to carbohydrate by the C3 cycle. CAM is a most significant pathway in a succulent plants. The stomata are closed during the daytime to avoid the transpiration loss of the water. As the stomata are closed, CO2 cannot enter into the leaves from the atmosphere. However, they can carry out the photosynthesis during the daytime with the help of CO2 released from the organic acid. During the nighttime, organic acid are synthesized in the plenty with the help of CO2 released in the respiration, and the CO2 enters from the atmosphere through the open stomata. Thus, the CO2 in a dark act as a survival value of the plants. Okay. Then we are discussing the differences between the C3 and C4 plants. Firstly, C3 plants. What is the difference between the C3 and C4 plants? One is the Calvin cycle is found in all the photosynthetic plants. In C4 plants, C4 cycles is found only in a certain tropical plants. Second one, the efficiency of CO2 absorption at the low concentration is far less, so they are less efficient. Fourth one is the efficiency of CO2 absorption at the low concentration is quite high, so they are more efficient plants. In third, the CO2 acceptor is in a C3 plant. CO2 acceptor is ribulose 1,5-diphosphate. In C4 plants, CO2 acceptor is phosphophenyl pyruvate, PEP. And fourth one is the first stable product is a phosphoglyceric acid in a C3 plants. And C4 plants, oxaloacetic acid, OAA, is the first stable product in C4 plants. In C3 plants, in each chloroplast, two pigment system, photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 are present. In C4 plant, chloroplast of the bundle sheath cells, the photosystem 2 is absent. Only one system is present, photosystem 1. And therefore, there are the dependent on the mesophyll chloroplast for the supply of the NADPH2. In C3 plant, CO2 compensation point is 50 to 150 ppm of CO2. And in C4 plant, CO2 compensation point is 0 to 10 ppm in CO2. Then in C3 plants, photorespiration is present and easily detectable. In C4 plant, photorespiration is present only to a slight degree or most often absent. Okay. Thank you everyone for listening this lecture.